liberated, proud of his heritage. Where the old Negro, it was more of the yes, massa type Negro or stereotype. And so the new Negro came out during the Harlem Renaissance, which basically speaks of the migration of black people from the South to the North, and how they was looking to just embrace their culture, embrace who they were as black people, and not have to depend on the white man for anything. They were proud of being inside of this little community they called Harlem. So yeah, that's what it means to be the new Negro. The new Negro is just proud of being black. So according to The New Negro by Locke, it states, the thinking Negro even has been induced to share the same general attitude, to focus his attention on controversial issues, to see himself in this distorted perspective of a social problem. His shadow, so to speak, has been more real to him than his personality. Though having had to appeal from the unjust stereotypes of his oppressors and traditors to those of his liberal friends and benefactors, he has had to subscribe to the traditional situations in which his case has been viewed. Little true social or self-understanding has or could come from such a situation. So basically they're talking about how the thinking Negro, and this has played a role in many of our lives today, especially inside of the 21st century, where a lot of black people are going to college, are graduating from college, and a lot of us are looked at as being too smart for your typical black person, or too black for even your typical white person. So, and a lot of us have had names such as, you know, Oreo, or, you know, the smart Negro, you know, where in here they call it the thinking Negro. That's a profound statement that Locke has made about, you know, how we're just treated, you know, when we're just exercising our normal right to think.
So as Sarita was saying, the 21st century Negro has kind of molded into someone maybe not fitting in because they're too white to be black, or they might have white qualities or tendencies, as some people may call them. But I also feel like the 21st century is a person who is liberated and loves everything about being black, loves every inkling about what makes them black. Movements like Black Lives Matter and Black Boy Joy and Black Girl Magic have really told society that it's okay to embrace your blackness and be okay with what's gonna happen to you. And I really feel like a lot of minorities in STEM and careers such as that field, they kind of want you to embrace your blackness and be the best that you can be. So that's what I think the